On September 18, 1993, at the age of 11, Victoria Van Meter set a record. She became the youngest female pilot to make a transcontinental flight. In June of the following year, at the age of 12, she flew a Cessna 210 from Augusta, Maine to Glasgow, Scotland, establishing the record as the youngest female pilot to make a transatlantic flight. She continued on with stops in London, England, Paris, France, and Frankfurt, Germany. In her travels, Vicki served as a goodwill ambassador for the city of Augusta, Maine, Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, and the United States of America. After her flights, she spoke across the country to people of all ages, encouraging them to follow their dreams. What follows is an actual speech Vicki presented at Take Your Daughter to Work Day in 1995 at NASA headquarters in Washington, D.C.
You know, it has been said, and a child shall lead them. And I think that is certainly very fitting today, because we will indeed be led by a very wonderful young woman who will share some very, very inspiring things with us. I'm very glad to be here at NASA today to celebrate Take Our Daughters to Work, and certainly to extend it to Take Our Children to Work, because we have with us today a number of daughters as well as sons. We want to celebrate also the notion of equal opportunity to achieve our dreams. I would like to use a videotape to introduce our next speaker, Miss Victoria Louise Van Meter.
Welcome to Inside Space. Today we're coming to you from the Hall of Science in Flushing Meadows, New York. Now, we've all heard kids say it, maybe you even said it yourself, when I grow up, I want to be an astronaut. Well, for one very special young girl, a space mission might be in her future.
It doesn't matter what age you are, it's just what you have in your head.
I know that anything she undertakes, she's going to finish. She's a very determined little girl.
It's just pretty special from the first, right from the first.
That I could handle flying across the country, so we decided to do this.
On September 20th, 1993, 11-year-old pilot Victoria Van Meter set out to do something that had never been done before.
I'll be the youngest female ever to fly across the country. It'll be the furthest distance ever flown, and it will be the first east-west.
It was a chilly Monday morning in Augusta, Maine, when Victoria began her record-breaking journey. Accompanied by her flight instructor, Bob Baumgartner, Victoria piloted her Cessna 172 airplane into the early morning skies. Her destination was San Diego, California, over 2,900 miles away. The first stop on Victoria's four-day flight was Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, where city officials made a special proclamation.
Today is Vicki Van Meter Day in the city of Harrisburg, and also that this week is Vicki Van Meter Week in the city of Harrisburg. Congratulations and welcome to the area.
Thanks.
When the official reception was over, it was back to work for 11-year-old Victoria, who checked weather conditions, filed her flight plan, and checked her plane's condition in preparation for takeoff. This was her flight from top to bottom.
She did it all. She flew the airplane, she did the navigation, and she talked to everybody.
Soon, it was time to head back to the skies. After additional stops in Columbus, Ohio, Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, and Phoenix, Arizona, Victoria's 4 days of flying brought her to the final destination, San Diego, California, and a place in history.
I feel good about what I've done, but we didn't think there would be this much people. We thought that there was just going to be a write-up in the paper or something, and that's it.
It may have been the end of Victoria's record-setting flight, but it was just the beginning of the excitement.
It's the Chevy Chase Show from Hollywood. Tonight, 11-year-old pilot Victoria Van Meter.
I know that you must have been a little surprised by the time you hit the Rockies, huh? A little bit of different air there?
Yeah, it was getting pretty bumpy in the plane. We were bouncing 200 feet, you know, and one thing. So even pilots said that they wouldn't have flown, you know, in that kind of weather. So I just had to fly through because I was setting the record. So it got me a little sick, but I tried not to think of that.
How sick? I mean, do you actually, you didn't throw up or anything, just a little queasy? You did throw up.
Well, maybe once, but I still was at the controls.
So. You were at the controls, so it was just a question of turning your head to the right and the cope.
Yeah.
And
pretty much.
And your instructor got it all.
Yeah,
okay.
But the best was still yet to come. The following week, Victoria flew to Houston for a visit to NASA's Johnson Space Center. There, she was greeted by NASA pilot Stephanie Wells and astronaut Tammy Jernigan. For Victoria, it was a dream come true.
Well, I hopefully someday want to be an astronaut or work with NASA, but I hopefully want to join the Air Force Academy.
Victoria was able to take a step toward her goal of being a NASA astronaut by spending time in an actual space shuttle trainer. And taking a turn flying and landing the space shuttle on a shuttle simulator.
Looking good.
All right.
Pretty landing. Very pretty.
Excellent.
If Victoria's performance on these tests are any indication, her dream of working at NASA could come true sooner than anyone imagined. Today, she's the youngest girl ever to fly cross-country. Tomorrow, she could be the youngest woman ever to fly in space.
Oh, how exciting. Vicki, that's incredible. The record-setting accomplishments of Miss Vicki Van Meter are inspiring, and they are the result of setting goals, working steadily to attain them. They're the result of tremendous family and community support, and they're the fruit of being focused, being disciplined, and having a strong desire to make her dreams come true. Miss Van Meter's accomplishments remind me of one of the lessons of Marion Wright Edelman, as she shared with her children in a recent book entitled The Measure of Our Success, and I offer these words. She says, if someone asks you to do A and B, and C obviously needs to be done as well, do them without waiting to be asked or without expecting a Nobel Prize for doing what is needed. If you see a need, don't ask, why doesn't somebody do something? Ask instead, why don't I do something? Don't wait around to be told what to do. There's nothing more wearing than people who have to be asked or reminded to do things repeatedly. Hard work, initiative, persistence, and I might add self-confidence and self-determination are still the non-magic carpets to success. Vicki is living proof that if you can believe it, conceive it, indeed you can achieve it. Hard work, initiative, and persistence are indeed